Now, in this video, I am not going to tell you who you should vote for to be the President of the United States.
I started off in Brooklyn. My father gave me a small loan of $1 million. Small loan of $1 million.
Small loan of $1 million.
Because that's the nature of a democracy, right? Everybody gets to choose who they want to vote for based on their own opinion without influence from other people.
And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab them by the pussy. Grab them by the pussy.
Grab them by the pussy.
let's just get right into today's video. Please don't vote for the fucking real life orange creamsicle that is Donald Trump, please! Here are a bunch of reasons why Canadians don't want Donald Dickface. Donald Trump to win and become the president. And I didn't go and like poll every single Canadian, okay? This is one Canadian's opinion, but I feel like a majority of Canadians will agree with me. I hope. Otherwise, I'm just gonna look like a fucking asshole. Now, the first and main reason that we don't want Trump to win is that we don't want you all to come to us. I hear it from so many Americans, so many like people who live in America who are on TV, on social media, who are like, oh,
if Trump wins, I'll be buying a first class ticket over to Canada.
And I feel like most Canadian people that I've seen like reacting to these jokes react to it as if it's like when you're in high school or at work and somebody says like an incredibly racist joke and you're all kind of just standing there like, move to Canada, oh, it's hilarious. Please fucking don't come! And I'm not just trying to shove like a shit ton of hate at Americans, cause like, not all Americans are shitty people, that's not what I'm saying. But like, if all the Americans came over to Canada after Trump wins, like, it's like having like a permanent family get together. It's like when you go to like a family dinner that's not only like your direct family, but it's like your second cousins, your family's family, you know, fucking Bob, who nobody really know. How is he a part of this family? Nobody knows! And at those get-togethers, there's always like the weird ass uncle, there's always that one aunt who's like a complete fucking bitch. There's always like that one kid who can literally do anything he fucking wants to with no reaper. Everybody just thinks it's cute. He fucking shits on grandma's leg and everyone's like,
oh my, is that little Jimmy? Did you just take a little poop on grandma's leg? Guys, it's okay. I mean, grandma hasn't been able to feel her legs since she got in that car crash back in 92. Poop all over them.
But at least like at those family get-togethers, eventually the people you hate will leave and then you'll just be left with all the people that you like. Thing about Americans all moving to Canada is that you're moving here, so you're gonna stay here, so we, you know, it's just like forever. And I don't want everybody to be pooping all over grandma's legs all across the country, that's all I'm saying. Another thing about all the Americans coming to Canada is like, you're coming over to Canada because you fucked up your own country. That may be like exaggerating a little bit, but you know what I mean, right? Like, Trump got elected, you couldn't do anything about it, so Canada. But what's to say, like, after all those Americans become Canadian citizens, that the next time we vote for a prime minister, the same shit happens to us because there's all these people coming in from the other country? Correct me if I'm wrong, but wasn't at one point in the States, there was a legit contender for the president named D's Nuts? I feel like that was a thing.
A candidate registered as an independent from Iowa has the legal name of D's Nuts.
Almost 1 in 10 voters in North Carolina say they prefer D's Nuts.
He may say the United States from whatever crisis we're in.
D's Nuts might be our savior.
That's it.
Ha! Got him! I've never seen someone like that in Canada. The biggest thing that I've seen compared to a ball sack in Canada is fucking Stephen Harper's face. But besides that, I've never seen anything that crazy. But if all the Americans come over, and by the time they're eligible to be able to vote for the leader of our country, I wouldn't be fucking surprised if a fucking broccoli became the prime minister, okay? Or fucking Harambe or something, I don't know. Well, now that I think about it a little bit more, if Trump wins, the only people that would come to Canada would be the Hillary supporters, so that wouldn't be as bad. If Hillary wins, and all the Trump supporters come to Canada, God, no! Vote for Donald Trump right now! And another thing about Americans coming over to Canada, people who have never been to Canada before will come here and realize that all these weird fantasy-ass stereotypes about Canada that all these people believe, they'll realize they're not true. And for like fucking 3 weeks, all we will be hearing is...
Man, you know what, Canada? It's, I thought it was cold here all the time! What's with this warm weather? Alright, just landed in Canada, the land of the beavers. Where are they? Wait, what? The sun comes over Canada? I thought it was always snowing over here! Okay, just got to Canada. Gotta get to my new house. Do you guys know where I rent my polar bear to, you know, to transport myself to my new house on the polar bear? You know, the thing that Canadians ride?
I highly doubt if you were on a polar bear. One, you would be doing this. If you were actually riding a polar bear, they would be trying to fucking eat your face, so you'd be like, boom! And Americans would also realize that in Canada, you can't buy alcohol from like 7-Eleven or like Walmart or Costco. You have to go to a liquor store. So I feel like the first little bit of Americans moving over to Canada, there will be a ton of fucking angry ass people inside like Costco and Walmart being like, dude, where's the fucking beer, man? The fuck is this bag of milk? If Trump wins and there's a huge flock of Americans coming over, could you guys please bring some of your fucking amazing food that you have in America that we don't have in Canada? If you wanted to just bring, you know, like a fucking truckload of Flaming Hot Cheetos, that would be awesome. And if you could just like pick up an entire Chick-fil-A and just like waddle that over and drop it down somewhere in Canada, we would also appreciate that because we don't have one. Well, at least where I live, there's no Chick-fil-A. So it'd be nice. I know I just talked like fucking a ton of shit about you guys. But I mean, if you're gonna come here, we might as well be family, right? So let's have a hug. Please don't fucking come here. If you guys are enjoying this video so far and I've made you laugh or I've offended you, I'm sorry. If you're enjoying it, be sure to kick that like button down below. And let's see if we can get this video to 20,000 likes, baby! I know the D Squad can do it, okay? And because this video like somewhat involves politics, there will be dislikes, guys. Dislikes are coming, okay? So if you guys could kick that like button, it would mean a lot to me. One reason why Canadians will want Americans to move over here is because when Americans come over here and they can't get a gun legally, they're gonna be pretty choked. If you watch any American YouTuber or you know anybody from America, they love their fucking guns. But I mean, it's not dangerous at all, right? Just like, guns are fine!
That was ricochet.
I can't hear anything.
Guys, they just use their guns for protection. Like, they would never fire their gun unless it was absolutely necessary. It's not dangerous at all! Like, give my fucking infant child a fucking Glock and he's all fun and games.
How did that feel?
Pretty good.
Yeah, it's all fun and games until someone gets fucking killed. It's all fun until, you know, shoots the instructor in the fucking face. Oh. I'm gonna give you some alternatives. So here are some alternatives for self-defense in your house. Do not attempt anything I am about to do at home, okay? This shit is very dangerous. You could hurt yourself very badly. Do not attempt to try it at all. Not with your parents, not at school, not at home. Thank you! Okay, classic alternative to a gun. You can buy this at any cooking store, any hardware store, anything. A knife! Someone breaks into your house and you want to scare them, just fucking pull out one of these from your kitchen that you just, you know, finish cutting a nice slice of chicken breast. Not only will I cut you and kill you, I'll give you fucking raw chicken disease! What's that called? Fuck, that would've been so much more funny if I would've known what it's called when you eat raw chicken! Raw chicken disease, that's the new thing. It also works a lot better as a self-defense mechanism if you know like some cool like knife tricks where you can like fling it. But, don't attempt this at home, guys. I'm a trained professional. There's a fucking hole in my hardwood now. Shit. Fuck, that's so bad. Do I have glue or something? Okay, if you absolutely cannot live without a gun, guys, there are tons of apps that you, like, it's the same thing, right? Like, someone breaks into your house, you hear them upstairs, right? You yell, "Hey, motherfucker! I got a gun down here!" Dude, it's the exact- they get scared and they run away! You're only like really fucked if they actually come down to like face you and you're just like it's a okay, go ahead and steal all of my shit. I'm gonna go. Now, some of you may not know that you can turn your blender into a self-defense mechanism very easily. Okay, so what you wanna do is you have like the bottom part of your blender, right? You have the top part, what you do to blend stuff. You do that and you go fucking, you know. Oh my God! That was scary as fuck and I wasn't even doing oh God! And all you have to do, say someone's robbing your house, you take off the blender part. So what you're left with is the glass and the blades. You put only this on here, and once you know... Oh my! I mean, that shit is on and you shove that into someone's face, they're gonna fucking die. What would you like to do? You see the robber, you're like, oh fuck, he's gonna rob me. Would you like to blend his face, grind his face, or liquefy his face? I think I'm gonna go with liquefy. Another good substitute for a gun is Vegemite, right? A robber comes into your house, he's got you at gunpoint, and you say, okay, before you take all my stuff, try a spoonful of Vegemite just because it's so amazingly delicious. Apparently Vegemite tastes fucking disgusting. I think it's a little unfair because you're not really supposed to get a big ass spoon of Vegemite and shove it in your mouth. You're really supposed to just, you know, rub it on some toast or something. So I'm gonna try it for the first time today, and I'm gonna take a big ass spoon and shove it in my mouth. So we're gonna take some Vegemite. Oh, what the fuck is that? Oh! Oh, feed that shit to somebody who's trying to steal all your stuff, you will get the fuck out of there right away! And I also just want to say, Canada is kind of like a hidden gem of the planet Earth. I feel like everybody else who wants to, you know, go somewhere where there's a shit ton of opportunity always talks about going to the States, always talks about going to America and get all this stuff, but I feel like everybody thinks America is so great. And don't get me wrong, America is an awesome country, but I feel like Canada is the best place. Like, Canada is such an amazing country. And I know the entire theme of this video was like, guys, don't come to Canada, we don't want you here. All jokes aside, if you're looking for somewhere to live and live a happy life, with healthcare, with awesome people, you know, with lots of opportunity, Canada is an amazing place to live. Whether you're from America, fucking South Africa, or if you have the chance and the opportunity to live somewhere, Canada is definitely your best bet. And again, I can't speak for everybody, but anybody who wants to move to Canada, we will welcome you with open arms, give you a big ass bottle of maple syrup, and you'll have to start watching hockey once you get here too. So, and that's not even a joke. If you live in Canada and you don't watch hockey, every single Friday someone will come to your house and beat the living shit out of you with a hockey stick until you actually start watching it. So, yeah. That was a joke. I would like to thank you so, so much for making it till the very end of this video and taking time out of your day. You know, you could be doing anything right now, but you chose to watch this video. Thank you so much. And if you enjoyed it, again, be sure to kick that like button down below. This may be the first video you have ever seen from me, so if it is, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you know when my next video comes out. You can also turn on post notifications too, so every time I post a video, your phone goes like bleep, and it'll tell you that, hey, this guy uploaded a video, and you can either decide to click on it and watch it or be like, fuck that guy, I'm gonna go watch PewDiePie. I don't know. If you have not yet added me on all my social media, Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat, those are all in the description. All of my DMs and messaging things are open on those, so you guys can send me messages, and I try to read as many as I can. So be sure to go and add me on all of those. If you guys live in America and you can register to vote, go and do that, because if you wanted Hillary to win and Trump wins, or you wanted Trump to win and Hillary won, and you complained about it, and you didn't fucking vote, then you can't complain and you're stuck with it for the next however long, 4 years? Probably should have looked that up before I made a video about politics. But you know what I'm trying to say! I will see you all very soon for my next video. I hope you enjoyed this one. I hope you have a wonderful day! And yeah, bye guys!